All right, now move around just a bit.
This is awkward.
Why are you so nervous? This is just a test.
Okay, okay, now what? Okay, that's enough.
Caroline, I swear, you are a natural.
Where did you get these anyway? Are the Mofang just giving you stuff now?
I mean, generously. Not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth.
This is the tree. It has been here in Hunrod for as long as anyone can remember. Its health is intimately tied to every...
We all lost everything. Everything but our stories. And they shouldn't be forgotten. I was 3. It was April of 1983. Cecil, it was 1870 for you. Sam and Vera, you'd tell it like it was yesterday, but it's been 62 years since you saw that blast of light. And that's where all of our news stories began, that light. It streaked across the sky, mesmerizing, but unnerving. Some of you were alone, I wasn't. My dear grandma, God bless her, rejoiced as if it was some forebearer of good fortune. Vera, you said you recall smiling. None of us understood. But, well, we followed. Whether it was in the deep woods like Cecil or right outside town like Jane and Jenny, we were drawn to see more. Grandma lifted me from the carriage on the porch and walked into the yard so we could watch it unobstructed. Even in daylight, Joseph, you said, was gloriously bright. But in the twilight, it was spellbinding. And we all felt some kind of trepidation, and yet attraction as we approached it, and it approached us. So close, so radiant, and that sound, deep and vibrant, organic. You all remember, there was no turning away. It advanced, almost like purposefully spinning slowly until, well, it found us, each of us. We should tell these stories because it saved us, and there must be more.
It was in the middle of the afternoon.
I was watching the sunrise.
It was about 2:30 in the morning.
December 26, 1948.
May 7, 2009.
September 3rd, 1995.
I was down by the river.
I was hiking in the desert.
In the park with my grandpa.
I looked up and saw
a brilliant flash of light
exploded in the sky.
The light just flew into the clouds and behind some trees
and disappeared. I looked around and, you know, to see.
To see if there was anyone around.
See if anyone else had seen what I had seen.
There was no one around.
They all saw it too.
Bob definitely saw it.
Well, it was just beautiful.
There was something calming about it.
Yeah, I don't mind telling you, I was kind of freaking out.
I tried to follow it,
studying it, but look at it.
Wanted to see it again.
I came to a place where it had disappeared,
overlooked, but I found nothing. And it streaked through the sky again.
It seemed like it was looking for something.
Or looking for someone.
And then it found me.
And it found me.
Found me.
Found me.
Found me.
Found me.
And it found me.